Why did the antivirus software go to therapy? Because it had too many trust issues. Ironically, it's me that has many trust issues with antiviruses. I mean, there are some really questionable apps out there. So today, I'm going to show you some of the worst and some of the best antivirus options that you can get. My search for the worst antivirus software unlocked a vivid memory of Protegent ads, which of course led to Protegent antivirus becoming a total meme. Not that it was any good before that. But security is not a meme, so if you actually want to protect your device, you can get a top-rated antivirus through the links in the description, and I'll review those in depth soon. Let's look at the ones I really don't recommend first. Like McAfee. Despite the fact that the creator of this antivirus software started hating the product, McAfee has everything you need to protect your device. Yeah, right, no. While it's not as bad as Protegent, the worst thing about this antivirus is that it often comes pre-installed on newly bought PCs and then is very hard to remove. I mean, you know it's serious when you have to get a dedicated tool for McAfee removal. On top of that, if you get the free version, be prepared to be absolutely bombarded with upgrade to premium pop-ups. Those scare the shit out of me each time. Even if you get a subscription, you'll just get new pop-ups pushing you to upgrade. Their auto-renewal is hell too, since they charge you without notice.
But Andy, who cares? It's good at detecting malware.
Yeah, I mean, if you want it flagging your legitimate files as malware and deleting them, sure. Get it? And then enjoy a slower PC too. Don't say I didn't warn you. Next up, we have Avast and AVG. And you might assume that I put these two together because they belong to the same company. No, no, that's not my issue. It's because they're literally the same app, just with different packaging. Now, to be fair, these two providers seemed like pretty good antiviruses. I mean, they get great independent testing scores, not just in malware detection, but in performance and usability too. So it all looked great until it didn't. Last year, Avast was fined $16.5 million for selling users' data. According to the Federal Trade Commission, they have been harvesting web browser information from at least 2014 up until 2020, and then sold it to more than 100 third parties. I mean, after this, I don't even need to complain about their annoying pop-ups. It's pretty safe to say that these two providers will probably never end up on my best antivirus software list. So then, what is a good antivirus? Well, I hope that it's already clear, but the reputation should be spotless. No data selling shenanigans or malware spreading accusations. I also want to see effective malware detection and removal. Not just during scans, a device needs to be protected 24/7. So I want to see real-time protection features too. Of course, regular updates are a given, and I also want to see flexible plans with extra tools. This way, each of us can tailor our antivirus to what we personally need. That may sound like a fever dream, but there are some best antivirus options that manage to fulfill these requirements, and they have been doing that for a long time now. For example, if we do a quick Bitdefender antivirus review, you'll quickly see why it is constantly among the best antiviruses for Windows 11 and 10 choices. This app is very beginner-friendly and easy to navigate, yet it packs some really strong security measures, from multiple types of scans to real-time protection that catch threats before they can damage your system. Bitdefender also has a firewall that monitors all incoming and outgoing traffic for suspicious activity, and you get ransomware remediation tools to back up and restore your files in case of a ransomware attack. Now, you don't need to take my word on how capable this antivirus is. Bitdefender has been collecting top ratings in various independent antivirus tests. In case you do want my opinion, I actually ran a test pitching this antivirus against 50 malware samples. With a full system scan, Bitdefender managed to remove 42 files in around half an hour. It was pretty intense on my CPU, but hey, it got great results, so I'm not complaining. And keep in mind, that was with real-time protection turned off. I actually ran a separate RTP test, and it kind of blew my mind a little. It caught all 50 files in a matter of a single minute. And that is why I keep repeating that this feature is essential for any best antivirus PC candidate. Of course, Bitdefender has more tools too, like the anti-theft feature, which lets you locate your device on Google Maps and even remotely lock or wipe it. The app has features to protect your microphone and webcam from unauthorized access, and you also get web protection against phishing attacks. There's a VPN too for extra privacy while browsing, though unless you pay extra, it's limited to 200 megabytes daily, which is a total bummer. Oh, and they have a password manager as well, so you can get a full cybersecurity bundle if you wish. Though personally, I use and prefer standalone tools. They're usually a bit more powerful. If you want to know more about choosing a VPN or a password manager or even a private browser, drop a like and subscribe to the channel. I have got plenty of videos on those topics. So Bitdefender gets my seal of approval, and I haven't even mentioned their full list of features either. So you'll have a lot of fun things to explore on your own. Of course, what you get depends on the plan you pick, but even the cheapest plan has all the necessary tools to protect your device. The only bummer is the two most affordable plans are Windows only. Well, a bummer for Mac users at least, but hey. Now, I often hear people saying that if you want really advanced protection, then pick Norton. So is Norton a good antivirus? Well, my main gripe with Norton was the overcomplicated UI with every feature opening in a new pop-up window too. But they fixed it. The new UI is actually pretty good. You can check it out yourself. Just scan this QR code to get their best offer or use the link in the description. It's going to auto apply the latest coupon code. But before that, let's dissect the Norton antivirus a bit more. They promise to protect you from all the common online threats like viruses, malware, spyware, and ransomware. And apparently, if your device ever does get infected with malware Norton can't remove, you'll receive a full refund. Talk about confidence. Anyway, it looks like they're really delivering on the promise. They got the maximum score in the latest AV test evaluation, and I haven't seen a lower score from them since 2014. In my own testing, Norton caught 45 malicious files in just 14 minutes, and their real-time protection actually got the same score. That said, those five remaining files aren't really a threat, because if they so much as wiggle their butts, Norton will clear them out in an instant. One of the things that makes me so sure about this is their smart firewall feature. It's one of the most advanced firewalls out there. You can also customize it if you're very tech savvy, but it already comes with a very solid protection without any tweaks. Just like Bitdefender, Norton Antivirus can also block unauthorized access to your device's webcam, though this feature is Windows only. But hey, we all know that Windows computers need the most help when it comes to battling malware, right? Additionally, Norton has a VPN and a password manager, but are limited as you'd expect. But they do their basic jobs well. I was actually even able to stream some foreign content with the Norton VPN, which for some reason, not many antivirus-related VPNs manage these days. At least Bitdefender's doesn't. Honestly, I could go on and on about Norton features like dark web monitoring to watch out for leaks, secure cloud backups to store sensitive files, disk optimizer tools for junk clean out. Norton Antivirus is full of customizable features, and you can tweak a lot of settings too. Build your own security for it if you wish. Of course, you can keep it simple with their cheapest plan, which still includes all the anti-malware tools and the 100% protection guarantee. The difference in plans comes from how many devices you get protection for, the extra features you can use, as well as the amount of cloud backup. But this way you can pick according to what you need. So yeah, that's two reputable best antivirus picks for you, and a couple of ones you should probably stay away from. Let me know what antivirus you have or plan picking, and if it's one of my recommendations, don't forget to check the description for special discounts. If not, comment below what other antiviruses you might like me to review, and I might just dedicate a video to them in the future. I'll see you around.